What's up, everybody? It is a Friday edition. We are in this mofo 2 weeks now, and time to break it down. I hope everybody's having a fun, happy, and healthy coronavirus 2020 lockdown. Things are definitely picking up. We're starting in Florida to get Amber Alerts now. Direct messages to our phone to tell us to stay inside. How many people around the country, I don't know if this is all over the country or just in Florida, just in the state of Florida, but this afternoon I got my phone blown up. They blow up my phone and tell me to stay home. What's a girl to do? Put on some music, make myself a margarita. That's right. Shout out to my friends at Herradura Tequila for a little high-level tequila. I got the music. I got the drink. It's all good. People are coming up on the Facebook Live. I'm so happy to see everybody. I'm hoping everybody is healthy. All your families are doing good. Anybody who comes down with this coronavirus, that they get a speedy recovery. All good. Survival rates are looking good on this thing. We have good immune system. You know why? Because in America, we're all a bunch of mutts. We're all a bunch of mutts. Like in the movie Stripes, they say that we're mutts in America. So USA has some good healing properties. We're all mixed together. I'm feeling this song so hardcore. I'm gonna have to like get up and dance in a minute. Love it. So listen, I'm gonna lower this a bit so I can get into the topic at hand. Cheers, girl. Love you, April Murphy. Hope you're doing well and your boys and everybody and your family's doing amazing. All right, let me lower this so we can get into the topic at hand, which is insecurity. Why are people so insecure in their relationships, singles or couples? A lot of people feeling insecure. Could be a bunch of different reasons, right? But it's something important, gotta handle it. And I'm gonna tell you how to handle it. I'm gonna tell you the mindset that one must get into so that they're not insecure. What's up, Susan? Cheers to you, girl. What's up, Stacy Connolly? Shout out to my girl up in Bogota, New Jersey, representing art. I can't even get into the topic because I'm jamming too hard at this music. I love it. Okay. Insecurity in relationships. Why are people so insecure? So there are many, many reasons for insecurity. Feel free to weigh in. You know, if you know why are people so insecure in relationships, you know, feel free to chime in, comment below. If you've ever been insecure in a relationship, I think we all can relate to that. We've all been in relationships where we're like feeling on edge and anxious, not good, not secure. Might be trying to fix the other person, hoping that the other person can, you know, change and be something different that we need them to be in order to make us feel nice and peaceful and calm. So it's always a challenge when you're feeling insecure in a relationship. So, oh, another good song. Oh my God, back to back. This is like WMC. Winter Music Conference is happening right on my balcony right now.
Cause I can't go low. Everybody get low. Had a couple hits and a couple solos. Now I got a couple bricks and a couple mobos. From far side, everybody
low. Mr. Ass is thinking I'm crazy.
With the polo. Now with a man, them in the polo. I can make a honey if I'm
winning. Okay. Crazy girl. All right, so insecurity in relationships. Like, I was talking today earlier with a beautiful girl. Beautiful, I mean, gorgeous girl. Who is my client, and she's lovely, but she admits super insecure in relationships, and she wishes, she's like, Lisa, I wish that I could, you know, feel secure, and like, if a guy's phone blows up, I'm not immediately paranoid that it's shady, and that he's cheating on me, or that he's doing shady stuff. So we had a conversation about that, And I said, you know what? That's a good topic for the quarantine, for the time where people now are, they're taking a break from dating, right? Because how are you dating? How are you dating if you're single? And even like, you know, this topic also applies to relationships too, because there are a lot of people in relationships where their person is busy and whatever and interacting with other people, and they have like a work wife or a work husband, and they have a relationship that's like a little intimate, even though it's work. It's very weird, and like there's a lot of boundaries that get overstepped. It's important that we have clarity so that this way we don't feel insecure in our relationships. Feeling secure in relationships is all our responsibility. It's all on us. We feel secure in relationships when we feel secure with our ability to take care of ourselves, meaning protect ourselves, protect our peace, be very clear on our standards. So what I did with my client today was that we dug into the root of her insecurity. And of course, it's common, abandonment issues, right? You fear that you're gonna be abandoned, so you get insecure that the person is doing shady shit and likes somebody better than you, and then you're just like, oh my God, what am I gonna do? So you start immediately feeling that fear of abandonment. So what we have to do is shift that. We just shift it into making her feel that people are free to come and go. They're gonna come and go. People, your whole life will come and go from your life. Come in, go. Come in, go. Your job, clients come, clients go. Jobs come, jobs go. The problem that we have is when we attach to stuff. Attaching to things, that is what gets us all anxious, all insecure, because we can't control the outcome. We can't control other people. We can only control ourselves. So to the degree by which we trust ourselves, that's the degree of security that we're gonna feel in relationships. When you don't trust yourself, you're not gonna trust anybody. You're not gonna trust anybody. You have to be able to trust yourself. Now, when I say trust yourself, what does that really mean? It means you can trust yourself to see red flags, and when you see them, to make a decision from there. The great late great Maya Angelou. Cheers to Maya Angelou. I'm taking a sip of the Herradura for Maya Angelou. Big sip, big girl sip. Maya Angelou said, when people show us who they really are, believe them, and then make decisions from there. A lot of times people are watching actions in relationships, and they're dating, and they're watching actions. Oh, beware the actions, watch the actions. Make sure you see what people are doing. Watch what they're doing, not just what they're saying. And that's fine and good, but what if they do something crappy or shady? So it's beyond that. It's listening to the words, watching the actions, and if they don't match up, it's taking an action for yourself. It's politely saying, you know what, this isn't working for me, and having the self-love to do that, to own what flies for you and what does not fly for you in relationships. So my client admitted that in her last relationship, she was with a narcissistic person, and in that relationship, her standards that she had for herself, they all went lower and lower and lower and lower. So she started to compromise her own standards in this particular relationship. She was like giving money to this guy, paying for him to move, all kinds of stuff. So really what he did was he used her. He glommed onto her. They weren't even together a month. Started already with moving in together, just didn't have the proper standards for herself to keep herself safe, to keep herself feeling secure. Secure that she can say yes and she can say no. And sometimes when we are dating people or in relationships with people to fill something that's empty in us, we make terrible, terrible decisions in relationships because we're looking outside of ourselves and into other people to fill up what we are missing. And only we can fill that up ourselves. Lisa, honey, hi from Fort Lauderdale. Cheers to you. I'm drinking a nice Herradura tequila mixed with some lime juice. And there's salt on the rim and some ice, and there's limes inside. I made a little homemade margarita. It's delicious. It's super cold and good. Mm-hmm. Mm. Do too much booze, man. I'm not getting the coronavirus. Hell no. No, not going out like that. So when you are in relationships and you're feeling insecure, it's really, really important that you do a check within yourself. It's really not about the other person, right? It's about how you handle yourself with that other person. So if somebody isn't coming at you honestly and they're being disingenuous or they're being shady and shifty, oftentimes when you call them out on it, they will flip it on you and blame you for being insecure. So let's say, hypothetically, I'm chilling with Mr. S, handsome Mr. S, and he's a looker, that one, let me tell you. So we're sitting down, let's say hypothetically, having whiskey straight up. Cheers, Peter, cheers to you. And let's say hypothetically, I notice his phone go off and it shows up with the name of a woman on his phone, and we're chilling watching like Ray Donovan or something, and like, boom, I look at his phone and it says like Maria. And I look at the phone. I have my energy in my relationship in such a way that if his phone blows up and says Maria on it, I don't even have to ask. He's gonna give me an explanation as to who is Miss Maria and why is she blowing up his phone at 10 p.m. on a Friday while we're trying to watch Ray Donovan. He will volunteer that information. That's how I have my energy in our relationship. And it's because it's rooted in respect, self-respect. First, nobody takes care of me better than me, ever. Nobody ever could or should. So I then would probably, you know, look at the phone, let him know that I looked at the phone. He would see me looking at the phone. I would make sure he saw me looking at the phone. And then I would look at him, and then he would probably say to me, oh, that's a chick from work. She's probably telling me that she's sending me this report that she was going to work on tonight and letting me know that it came. Oh, all right, fine, all good. But now I have Miss Maria in my brain, all good. If she pops up again, okay, let's see what happens. But I am prepared that if some shady shit goes down with this Miss Maria chick, I am bouncing. I'm out. And here's why. And this is what I told my client. You need to attach your security to something greater. So for me, it's my business. I have a very clear vision of where I'm going in my life and in my business. I do not have the bandwidth for bullshit at all. So if a man is going to be entering my life, he needs to bring me peace and he needs to bring me just calmness in my life. If you're gonna add drama to my life, you're out. I don't have the bandwidth. I'm helping people. I am coming at you guys with content every day. I have to be like high vibe all the time. Like, I can't be dealing with drama and bullshit. Like, you need to be a team. You need to roll with me. You can't be, you know, coming into this relationship and bringing drama and chaos and awful. So hold it together, otherwise you're out. Like, the analogy that I gave to my client, and I'm gonna take another sip. Take a sip, it's time for a sip. Anybody who has a cocktail, let's do this shit. Mm-hmm. Ooh. Full straight Herradura tequila, little bit of ice, beautiful lime juice, cap full, shaken, put in the cup, delicious, amazing. Beautiful sipping tequila. Oh, this is a jam right here. I don't know who's gonna know this song. It's a little obscure, but I love it. Baby, they're playing your jam. Like this song. I know it. Yeah, Joe Bean knows it. Good tune. Ready? That I was dreaming of ever since I was a little. You are the girl. Louder. Let's do it. Let's get into it. Love it. I just love the the bass line. All right. My playlist is on fire. I love that Joe knows that song. It's awesome. So have you guys ever been in like a relationship where you felt totally insecure and you were like almost crazy, like it made you crazy? You were just like, dude, I don't like who I am in this relationship. I don't even like it. Like, this chick's got me sprung, or this guy's got me twisted. Like, honestly. When am I ever like this ever in my life ever? That's a warning sign. When you feel it in your body, where you're like, you feel it in your heart, you feel it in your gut, and you're just like, what is the deal? Why am I so anxious and out of sorts in this relationship? That is a signal that that is not the right relationship for you. Your relationship vibe should be like chill, peaceful, chill. I'm gonna do a little sip. Two cheers to peaceful, happy relationships. Here you go. So Mr. S just told me he's going to the roof. Taz, why are you barking? Come over here and come say hi to the people, Tipe. Come say hi to the people, Tazer. It's a Friday. We got a good happy hour going. Come here. No, you don't like it? Okay, fine. Stay on the floor. What do you want from me? Insecurity in relationships. That's what we're talking about here on Facebook Live. The quarantini, that's right. Every day, until further notice, until it gets too hot for me to even be out on my balcony, I am bringing you a happy hour quarantini. Everybody on the lockdown. Today, they blew up my phone. I was saying earlier when I first hopped on the live, they blew up my phone. They, the big brother, and they said, stay in your damn house. What's up, Florida? Right on my phone. I'm like, how the hell did you get my number, bro? And this is the thing, it's the AI. I have, lower this a tad. So I have Verizon, I have Verizon. Shout out below with the cell phone carrier that you have. Shout out below. Are you on 5G yet? You're still rolling 4G. That's another big controversy. 5G. A lot of radiation going on in the atmosphere. 5G, this whole thing. Okay. Let me tell you what. These people blew up my phone and they told me to stay home. I was like, dude, what are they going to do next? So I said, you know what? I'm just going to chill here like I do every day in the 5 o'clock hour. Today I went 6 o'clock because I had a client who needed me. He had a little session. I also needed to get some ice up in this mo. We had no ice, which is a problem. We need to have ice. And I wanted to hit the Walgreens on the corner so that, you know, I didn't have to go later because they're closing in at 9 o'clock now. It's a shutdown here in Miami. Everything's shutting it down. And right now, we're in very insecure times, too. We're all feeling insecure. So, really, you want to feel insecure in your relationship, in addition to the lack of security that we feel for what's going on in our country right now, in the world right now? You know, the UK is full-on lockdown. Full-on. And they fine you. They're fining people. £30, it said, if they're on the street when they shouldn't be. So this is what we're coming to, people. Welcome to the Hunger Games. Tell me what district I'm in. Cheers. I'm in the tequila district. Tonight, I am definitely in the tequila district. So let's see who's on the live right now. I see Alana Bodner. Girl, it has been a minute. I wish you love and light. I hope you're doing well. Love to catch up with you. Mitch Novick is online because Mitch Novick knows what's up with this beach. Mitch is the man to talk about South Beach. He knows exactly what's going on this beach. So we're talking right now about feeling insecure in relationships. What do you do when you feel insecure in a relationship? And it's normal, right? It's normal. It doesn't make it good. It doesn't make you feel good. So I'm sitting here telling people, listen, you got to feel secure in yourself. And to the degree by which you feel that you can keep yourself safe in a relationship. And what do I mean by that? I mean, you detect bullshit and you bounce. You call that person out and you say, with all the love in your heart, you want to come to understanding. You're not accusing anybody of anything. but you're going to be very clear that you don't like what's going on. You're going to say, hey, I have a question for you. I noticed that, and I'm sure there's something of an explanation. I just noticed lately that there's been a lot of activity on your phone. You know, there's been a lot of, you know, people, a lot of buzz. Is everything okay? Asking is everything okay is always the best question to ask people because it shows concern. It diffuses them. You're not accusing them of anything. You're showing concern. Is everything okay with you with work? I feel like your phone is going off a lot. What's that about? Like, concerned about you. And then you see their reaction. If they're flustered, oh, my phone's not going off that much. Oh, okay. It kind of is. Like, for the last couple of nights, I noticed there's like a lot of late night, you know, phone activity happening. Are you okay? Is everything okay with work? Like, you're already giving, you know, an assumption, like all is well. And then you watch the reaction. Watching you, bro. That's what that is. I'm watching you because I got me. I got me first. Always first. And a lot of people, they give the benefit of the doubt because they want to believe. They have to believe that everything's cool. So ask yourself, why do I have to believe? Why do I have to believe so much that this person is not bullshitting me? Why do I have to believe that so much? What is it in me that has to believe that so much? I see bullshit right in front of me and I have to believe whatever lie, whatever bullshit they're serving up, I have to believe it? No, I don't. Explore that within yourself. Have you ever had a situation where you're like, damn, I ignored the red flags. I saw the red flags, drama, 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 and I ignored them. That's the opportunity. That's the opportunity that you have now to look at that side of yourself and commit to keeping yourself safe, keeping yourself happy, harmonious, protected, making some decisions for yourself, setting some standards for yourself. It's a very important thing, setting standards. I did standards work with my client tonight. It was amazing. 2 hours ago, I think we were on the phone. It was amazing. And she was like, wow, you know what? I used to have standards. I used to have like some hardcore standards. And I let them fall and fall and fall. And certain people, toxic people, people who are angling for their own agenda, psychologically, they will mess with you to get you to lower your standards one at a time. And that's kind of like what we're seeing our government doing with us. Look at us all. We're not allowed to go out anywhere. We have to stay 6 feet away from one another. They want us isolated and separated and desperate and insecure, because then we ask for a solution. We're like, oh my God, I'm so insecure. Like, I can't pay my rent. I can't pay my mortgage. Oh my God, I'm so insecure. I'm so insecure. Like, please help me. Like, please give us. They created this mess, and then they're going to come with the solution. Understand the process. Understand it. Right? So, in your relationships, if somebody's creating drama to get you to think about needing them to eliminate the drama, you're going to them for your peace. You're going to them for their peace. So you're saying, oh, who's this person blowing up your phone? And like, what's the deal with the social media? Like, why, who's this chick on your Facebook who keeps liking your stuff and this and that? So you're asking the person, the very person who's inflicting the disrespect, inflicting the pain, to solve the pain for you. That's dangerous. You solve your own pain. You handle your own pain. Something is real. Red flag, alert, alert, alert. Bullshit, bullshit. This is bullshit. You owe it to yourself to have security in yourself, to have trust in yourself that you can hold it down for you better than anyone could or should, and you own your truth, and you don't think, oh my God, if I say something, they're not going to like me anymore. If they say something, oh my God, it's going to be World War III. If I say something, they're going to leave me. There's the door, bro. There's the door. I had a conversation with another client where they were like, You know, we were salt, love it, love it. Cheers. A break. But a break. Cheers. Herradura with some lime. Amazing. And salt on the rim. So I was having a conversation with somebody else, client, and they said, what about when they call you insecure? Like, they tell you you're insecure, and so they're just indoctrinating you. They're trying to make you doubt yourself. The mind games. Scrambled brain. Mind games. Mind games. Listen, here's the deal. If you smell a rat in the wall, you need to say something. Do not exist in a relationship where you are thinking that everything is cool, but yet your gut instinct is telling you something shady. Crap going on with this virus. I was one who ignored red flags. Ugh, I need to stop looking for it so hard and let it find me. You're making me thirsty with that drink. Oh my God. Okay, so yeah, back to the red flags. So when you're thirsty for a relationship, you're gonna ignore red flags. When you're desperate for a relationship, oh my God, this song. Oh my God. Do you guys remember this song from like the late 90s, early 2000s? Chemical, is it Chemical Brothers? Listen to this. Yeah. Ready? Here it goes. Ready?
Trip like I do. Trip like I do.
I'm ready to have a rave. Do you remember raves? Love it. I can't love it any more than I love it right now. Friday night in Miami, I got the sunset happening like right past this phone, boom, on the Biscayne Bay, and I can see it from my balcony. Sunset happening, beautiful light, the clouds, amazing. No, it's a miracle to be alive right now. Amazing. Palm trees, look, hi, right there. Look, I can like reach through my balcony and like touch palm trees right there. No. Blessings all around. So, feeling insecure in relationships, it sucks, and you don't deserve it. That's not a relationship. So this is the best part of this song right here. The best part. Like 90s parties in like a warehouse.
Oh my God.
In Brooklyn. A freight train, I'm going in. By myself. This is what happens when you're alone for days and days and days and days and days and days. So listen, if you guys are out there and you're feeling insecure in your relationships and you're just like, dude, I gotta handle this shit. I can't date like this anymore. When this whole coronavirus thing blows past, which it will, and you go out and about dating again or you're in a relationship, this is the time to take some stock in how you're handling yourself in your life, in your relationships. This is the time to make some new standards and commitments for how you're gonna roll. Look at this like the end of a chapter. You're living your life, la 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 la, and the universe lowering this a little bit more. The universe came at you and said, all right, listen, I'm going to put you in a timeout because you are running amok. You are Bumble and Hinge and all these things and out and about. And then in the relationship, you're this, you're fighting with each other. You need to be in a timeout. You need to reassess your life. You need to think about what brings you true joy and happiness in your heart. Set some standards for yourself. Be like, I'm not dealing with any kind of bullshit that's going to rattle my peace. Make your peace number one priority. I always say that to people. That is what brings you security. Tony says it. Tony, honey, I'm with you. You're with me. I'm with you, bro. I'm with you. You're with me. Tony Nicholas, new standards. Bravo. So what new standards? When you think of coronavirus, right? There was a time before, and now there's this, and now there's going to be a time after. So pre-coronavirus, you were dating like the way you were dating, or you were in a relationship functioning the way you were functioning. This is a time to start a new chapter. This is a time where you can say, you know what? Wipe the slate clean, honey. I'm going out this way now. I'm changing the game. I had, my God, what are we talking? 2 weeks already of this bullshit. You know how much reflection, self-reflection? A lot of people are cleaning their apartments, right? They're cleaning their apartments. What's up, baby? You back? People are cleaning their apartments. You know how meditative cleaning is? You're in there and you're scrubbing and you're working shit out. You're thinking about like where you are in your life and you're scrubbing the bathroom floor for the 27th time this week. And you're just like, all right, toilet, scrubbing, scrubbing, mold out, back, wiping surfaces constantly. When you're doing that, you're thinking, you're working stuff out. Trip like I do. We got a phone, wow, we got a song request. I can't do any like thing because I have a phone, and so I can't switch and then put a different song on, unfortunately. But right now, we got this song going. I don't know if people know this song from, wow, I want to say this song's from early 2000s, right here. Here we go, ready? Do you know this song? Who knows this song? Music sounds better with you. Love it. All my stuff, all my old. This is New York. So New York. Oh. The old New York. That's right, Peter. You know what's up. You know what the good music is. Music Sounds Better With You by Stardust. That's right. But you know what? Sometimes, when you're with a toxic person, the music sounds better by yourself. Ever do that? You got through a breakup and then you're in your car and you just crank up music and you feel so much better. You feel so much better. You're like, oh my God, I gotta shake this off. I gotta shake off this energy and put some good energy into my life, bro. So look, if you are in a situation where you feel insecure in your relationships, please reach out to me. That is no way to live in relationships. You deserve way more than that. God did not put you here to be sitting around wondering if this person is into you or not, if they like you, if they're committed to you, if they have your best interest at heart. This is anxiety. This is like anxiety thinking. Gotta handle yourself. You gotta be like, all right, listen, I sniff bullshit. If I'm gonna call bullshit and bullshit is present, I'm gonna bounce. You gotta protect yourself. So I'm hopeful that you like my tunes. Cheers to everybody out there. Oh my God, safe weekend. I'm probably gonna be doing these more over the weekend because, you know, it's not like I can be going anywhere. So I'm gonna be hanging out on my balcony a shit ton. And look, if you have insecurities about your relationship, if you're doubtful about the person that you're with, if you feel like there's something up there and it's not hitting you right, you need to start making decisions for yourself. You're the only person who can keep yourself safe. And that's what it's all about. Not to say that you have to exist in fear, but exist in your own power. Exist in your own power to recognize when something is not good for you, time to go. Time to go. And the people who are the most insecure are the people who doubt their ability to leave something that is not good for them. You don't know that you can leave something that is not good for you? Let's get together, because that's safety shit, dude. What's up, Tony? Peace, my love. Peace, my love. Listen, give this a like. Give this a share. I'm sure people in your circles could benefit from the high vibe and benefit from the information that I'm giving you tonight. Gotta feel secure in yourself so that you can handle these people and start attracting better people into your life. When you're secure in yourself, you attract kings and queens. You're not dealing and dabbling in the mediocrity when you could keep yourself safe, keep yourself whole and happy and peaceful. So protect your own peace. Think positively, dude. This is mind games. So all this is mind game. I love all of you. You can find me at lovequestcoaching.com. I'm Lisa the Love Coach, certified professional life coach, energy leadership master practitioner. I can raise vibe like mofo. You're in a low vibe. You're fearing this whole corona thing, and you're in fear and lack and freaking out. Get with me. Half hour together. I promise you, I'm going to show you some tools that you can use to get yourself out of fear and into faith and into moving forward, keeping yourself in a right mind so that your immunity is good. All this is a mind game. It's a mind game. Are you going to go down the path of negative, or are you going to keep it positive? Your life depends on it. So let's connect. If I can help you, I would love to connect with you. Thanks so much, you guys. Have a great night. Bye.